Oh yeah, we have this. This is a bit of an odd one, and something that I'm kind of ashamed to talk about here. But fuck it, you know, sometimes you have to be a bit cringe and give yourself the flowers whilst you're here. So I saw this really cool thing on my feed the other day from Virgil Abloh, where he posted this image. This is courtesy of his Instagram page, that says the following: at Rob 1970, leading conceptual artist from my school of thought. The first object just launched now via Canary Yellow Art Store, the art object outlet for the motley crew of artists I roll with. Robert Cristofaro, obviously from A-Life fame, born 1970, American artist, small compact carton cutter, New York City 2020. And obviously what you see in the picture here is Rob's interpretation of a carton cutter. It's got his kind of, you know, acronym or his logo or his name here, Rob 1970. Embossed on the outside with an engraving of 2020 written there, an edition out of 200, I think. That one's number 49. You got some images there of the book cutter. You got it here in the box itself. It looks pretty decent, stainless steel, all well and good, right? So I was thinking, you know what? I'm going to take credit for this collaboration, because I think I was the person to introduce Rob from A-Life and Rob from A-Life and Virgil for the first time, or maybe reacquainting them, but I think it was for the first time when I was working at my previous place, you know, a few jobs ago, maybe it was 6 7 years ago. Obviously I was in charge of leading, or I was in charge, I was put in place to co-produce a streetwear program, which basically meant, you know, I kind of had to dip into all my contact books of people that I've known and grown up with or looked at when I was doing my thing, and kind of, you know, ask them that, hey, if you want to come on this course, where Virgil Abloh was the kind of lead curator, the lead lecturer in this, right? It was very new at that time, something a bit fresh. I think it kind of built upon something Jeff Staple might have done ages ago, but, you know, that's Jeff Staple. He's a bit lame, so no one really cared. So the idea behind it was to give brands all over the world access and resources to information that they probably wouldn't have if they didn't live in a metropolitan city, and obviously access to some of the biggest and brightest brains within streetwear and fashion and menswear, whatever it may be. And the idea was to get them from inception to delivery, so they can take their idea, what they had in their head for a streetwear brand, and take it all the way to how it would look in the rack and how you'd get it in the shop and how you'd sell it. And obviously, you know, I was able to kind of pull in some favors, go through my contact list and got some names. And one of the names that I pulled out that I thought would be really good, obviously, because I'm a big fan of A-Life. I remember going to the A-Life store when I went to New York in the early, late 2010s or something around that sort of line. I bought quite a few jumpers as well from A-Life from back in the day. No, it wasn't from A-Life. It was from a Good Hood sample sale. But I did bump into Rob from A-Life in New York back in the day. I forgot the sneaker store that they had that was all brown and mahogany that was linked to them. I think it was Rivington something, right? Do you remember that store that was linked to A-Life that had all the things in it? I remember having the Adidas's, the A-Life Adidas's back in the day too, the red ZX700s, I think, from back in the day. And anyway, Rob's just generally a very much a bit of a legend. Obviously, he has a child with Leah McSweeney from Married to the Mob, so they are essentially streetwear royalty in that respect, right? They're cut from a different type of cloth from that back in the day, what they called it, streetwear mafia days, right? From back in the day, if you remember that era. Smash the like button. So I think I was the first person to reintroduce these guys in a working capacity. And then Virgil Abloh ended up flying out Rob to his show in Paris, which I went to attend. I think that was Fall Winter. That might be Fall Winter 2015 of Off-White, if I'm not mistaken. The one where Ian Connor runs down the runway. I was there for that one, standing on the side. Obviously didn't get a seat. Not that special. I think it was Off-White. Is it Off-White Men's 2015? Let me see. Think so. Off-White Men's 2015. Let's see if it was that one. It was yellow. The floor, the kind of set design was yellow. Okay, it's not 2017. Was it 2017? It didn't feel like, I felt longer, more long than that. Okay, maybe it was 16 then. Is it 16? Let's see if it was 16. 2016. Yeah, that's one. It was 2016. This collection. If you remember that, let me see if I can find it actually. Yeah, it was definitely this one. I got it here already on the list. Let me get it up on here so you guys can see. But this was the one, yeah. So around this time, I obviously enlisted Rob to be one of the guest curators sorry, guest lecturers on the program, you know, to work with Tandem, with Virgil, in terms of, you know, helping out some of the brands that are on the streetwear program. And then I guess throughout that communication, or throughout that kind of time, Rob and Virgil got talking again. Virgil ended up inviting Rob over to Paris to come, you know, just hang out, vibe in the studio, as he always does. It's always kind of, you know, helpful that way, always collaborating with people and reaching out to people that he feels can kind of add something to the overall vibe of what he's doing, maybe inform some of the last minute decisions of clothes that go on the runway. And yeah, he was here somewhere. I'm pretty sure I was on standing somewhere towards that right hand side of this, but I'm pretty sure I was the first person to reintroduce these people back together. So when I see stuff like this, I feel a bit of pride. I'm not going to be honest. I want to give myself a pat on the back for that. And then of course it's available on his site, you know, you've got Virgil Abloh's site here, you know, all the points that he's sort of working on, you know, maybe great to see. Awesome, hardworking dude. And then of course there is the box cutter itself, marked at £15, that you can purchase. Obviously it's, you know, practical and also a bit of an art piece in itself as well, so a fairly decent little object there. But yeah, I saw that, I was thinking, you know what, I think I'm responsible for this. I think I might have led to this collaboration actually going on. So, you know, in an era where everyone is eager to give people their flowers, I'm gonna give myself flowers for doing a sterling job. This is probably the best job I did, actually, working in a place somewhere that wasn't my own thing. Obviously I do pretty decently in terms of the stuff I do myself, but in terms of doing an actual work job, 9 to 5, clocking in, that was probably the best performance I was able to do, mostly because it was something that I kind of, you know, I've always loved in it when it comes to streetwear, something I've kind of been obsessed with from when I was super, super young. So it came really easy to me in that respect. Just a shame that it ended in a somewhat shitty way, pun intended. If you know, you know. But yeah, big up Rob, big up Virgil. Collaboration looks pretty sick. Big fan of it. Glad they're still going strong and still friends and all that malarkey.